Welcome everyone to this course on PyVision Migrating PyProcessBook Displays. My name is Kristen Winicky. I'm a product support engineer specializing in our visualization products, which include PyProcessBook and PyVision, and I'll be the instructor for this course. This course is a technical, hands-on course where we will be focusing on how to use the PyProcessBook to PyVision migration utility. As PyProcessBook is our oldest visualization tool, you may have invested large amounts of time and resources to developing PyProcessBook displays to effectively provide data to those in your company. However, as PyProcessBook is a thick client that was initially developed 25 years ago, this application has begun to show its age. Moving forward, PyVision is our leading visualization tool, which is a thin client built to leverage the latest Py system capabilities, where PyProcessBook has fallen behind. We do understand that it takes a lot of hard work to build out PyProcessBook displays, and we want to help move that work over to our modern visualization tool and take advantage of the benefits of PyVision. Therefore, we have developed the PyProcessBook to PyVision migration utility. While it may seem like a daunting task to migrate a large number of displays, this course will give you the knowledge and practice to be confident in using the migration utility. By providing a test environment where you can practice migrating PyProcessBook displays to PyVision, by the end of the course, you'll have a better understanding of how the migration utility works and what configuration options are available for your displays. In addition, we will review the reporting options available in the utility to provide a granular look into the results of the migration. Outside of the migration utility itself, you'll be able to understand how display interaction works in both PyProcessBook and PyVision after this course to help prepare you to understand how displays will work after being migrated. Finally, we will further build out and update migrated PyVision displays leveraging Asset Framework and PyVision. The background and scenario for this course is that you have recently been hired as a Py administrator at the Flint River Hydro Company, and your first task as Py admin is to migrate their PyProcessBook displays to PyVision. Py users at the company rely heavily on these PyProcessBook displays, so you want to make sure all the data on these displays is available in PyVision after migration. Luckily, the company uses Asset Framework and has built out an AF database for their buildings and equipment using templatized AF assets that they have used in their PyProcessBook displays. The AF hierarchy, shown here and on page 5 of your workbook, features three main levels under our company element called Flynn River Hydro. Underneath that, we have Flynn 1 and Flynn 2, which are the hydro unit elements. Within each hydro unit element, there are generation unit elements. There are two generation units within each hydro unit. And the last level is the equipment within each generation unit. So each generation unit will have one generator and one turbine. As mentioned previously, this AF structure has been utilized in most of the PyProcessBook displays, and we want to make sure we keep that AF structure in our migrated PyVision displays. One note about this AF database is that it is a modification of the Hydro Plant Monitoring Asset-Based Py Example Kit, which is available on PySquare if you would like to download this asset-based Py example kit for later use. In this course, we will work with the cloud environment, which contains the following components: access to Active Directory, Data Archive 2017 or later, AF Server 2017 or later with Py System Explorer, PyProcessBook 3.0.15.7 or later, PyVision 2019, and PyProcessBook to PyVision 2019 Migration Utility Patch. For all of the exercises in this course, we will be working with the PySRV 01 VM. In the activities that follow, we ask you to share with other participants some information about yourself, including your industry, company, and role within your company.